I don't have a garden.
But don't you want one? One of your own, I mean? Well, come and look at your seeds, why don't you? Well, if you don't want them, I'll take them back to me mother.
I want to go in that garden, where Robin lives.
Well, I wasn't sure you'd seen him.
Seen him? He's done nothing but chirp at me ever since I got here.
You have to understand, Mary. He's making his nest, and he can't afford to have you interfering if you're not friendly.
How do you know that?
Because we was just talking about you. How do you think?
He was talking to, or just you?
What he thinks is that you're looking for a nest yourself. Only it looks to him like your nest would have to be pretty big.
Have you ever been in there?
Oh, it's not mine to go into, Mary. But it might be yours, I can't say. He's been keeping it safe for somebody, that much I do know.
He has.
Same way as the ivy, grown up to hide the door. But maybe Robin is waiting to hear why you want to go in there exactly. Being as he's got the safest nesting spot in all England, he's wise to be wary.
Could you tell him I'm friendly?
I could. But what if you wanted to tell him something else and I wasn't here? It'd be much quicker if you'd learned to talk to him yourself.
But what could I say that he would understand?
Well, I wouldn't mention that you were an egg eater, if you know what I mean. But, are you interested in flying, perhaps? Or bugs?
I'm afraid not!
Well then, just tell him about yourself, and I'll translate into Yorkshire for you, till you get the way of it.
I'm a girl.
She is a lass. Has took a greatly fancy to thee. Dost thou fear?
Thou not fear.
She took thee on for lack to vex thee. Now to the sword.
Now to the sword.
She knows farewell, she moon not fright thee.
Can ever show me.
Fair better to know her.
Show me the key.
Show her the key. She's a lass and thou art right. What needs a spot where she can rest in?
I not sit where I'm not be so thinking thoughts or feel a guest in.
Now to the salt.
Now to the salt.
She'll fair be watching for the spring.
I'll not be climbing up. I'll only be calling good morning and follow or sing.
Well done, Mary.
Lily, what are you looking for?
Oh, wait till you see it. It's the most beautiful garden I've ever seen. And nobody knows about it except Archie. But the door's so covered over with ivy that I can never find it. Oh, wait. Perhaps it's on this other side.
I'll only walk around as like to see it for myself. If thou canst allow me visit, pause be glowing to thyself. Thou not be bothered night and day by wenches racing round. All but seem a silent dream, standing on the secret ground. I but smell the growing things, count the roses against the walls. Hear thy bait and first thy peck, stretch my hands if they should fall. For if thou likes, I'll bring thee seeds or worms all in a mound. For if thou have me for a friend, thou'll be the first I found. I'm a lass,
a trusty lass,
that took a greatly fancy to thee. Can ever show me,
farewell dost thou know her,
show me the key,
show me the key. Well, I'm off then.
But where are you going?
I can't say, but I'll see thee tomorrow sure enough. And if you need me before then, well, now that you and Robin is talking, he always knows where I am.
But can't Robin look for the key?
But that's why I'm leaving, Mary. A body can't find a thing in a crowd.
All right, then. Bye!
And you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe it all the day. Stoop and feel it. Stop and hear it.
Wants us in the house. Right? No! Mary!
Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master ate. Tiptoe the chambermaid and stole their pearls. Snip, snip the gardener and cut off their curls.
Will this rain never stop?
Archie, I'm so pleased. I have finally located a suitable school for young Mary.
A school?
She needs the company of other children, particularly after a tragedy such as this.
But she's practically just arrived, Neville. Does she want to leave?
This is no house for a child. What will she do here? Wander the halls?
As I do, you mean? What a wretched house. Father should have given Misselthwaite to you, Neville, not me.
You are the elder brother, Archie. That never would have occurred to him. But if you feel you cannot live here, then leave. You were happy once before in Paris. You're still a young man. There is
no... I can't leave, Neville.
But what good does it do to sit by the boy's bed night after night hoping for a miracle?
They have been known to happen.
When Lily died, I gave up my
practice. You have been completely faithful, Neville. I am deeply grateful.
But I did not give up my responsibility to you, Archie. I cannot allow you to waste your life waiting for the inevitable end.
I'm not wasting my life, Neville. This is my life now.
I beg your pardon, sir. You sent for your Mary.
Yes, child. Come in. Perhaps we could manage to have a moment before the storm carries us away. Take a chair.
Thank you, sir.
Are you well? Do they take good care of you?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry it's been so long since we've spoken. It's just I keep forgetting you. I intended to find you a school
but
to
no,
go to.
Please don't send me away.
No, of course not. But perhaps you would enjoy a governess, considering you've had a chance to look round now and know there's nothing for you to do. What do you say to that?
Please don't make me have a governess, sir. There's everything for me to do here. There's so many gardens to walk around in, and so much to learn about them. And Martha gave me a skipping rope. And Dickon gave me some seeds.
And here's a rose for you,
yes,
Mary.
Yes, all right. Then.
Happy birthday, darling.
Play outside if you like. But is there anything you need? Would you like some toys or books or dolls, perhaps?
Might I have...
Speak up, child.
Might I have a bit of earth, sir?
A bit of earth?
To plant seeds in. Yes, sir, a garden.
Do you care about gardens so much, then?
I didn't know about them in India. I was always ill and tired, and it was too hot. I sometimes played making the flower beds by sticking things in the sand. But here, I might have a real garden. If you will allow it, sir.
Are you sure there's nothing else?
No, sir.
Yes. All right, then. You may have your earth. Take as much earth as you want.
Oh, thank you very much, sir.
You may leave, child. It's much worse being back this time. The dreams are much more vivid, and I hear things in the halls. It's the girl.
Do you mean Mary? But I never see her.
Because you can't see her, Archie. Because she reminds you of Lily.
You can't be serious.
I can see the resemblance myself, although Lily's hair was small. You were very kind to take the girl in, Archie, but in your present state, it is simply too much. If you allow this girl to stay here, to grow up here, I have no doubt your dreams, to say the very least, will get even worse.
But you can see she's lonely, Neville. Perhaps I should have more conversations.
I do think that would be wise.
A bit of earth.
Until you are ready to send her to a suitable school.
She wants a little bit of earth. She'll plant some seeds. The seeds will grow. The flowers bloom, but is their bounty what she needs? How can she chance to love a little bit of earth? Does she not know? The earth is home, and it doesn't care if one small girl wants things to grow. She needs a friend, she needs a father, brother, sister, mother's arms. She needs to love, she needs to dance and learn to work her girlish charms. She needs a home, the only thing she really needs, I cannot give. Instead she asks a bit of earth to make it live. She should have a pony gallop across the moor. She should have a doll's house with 100 rooms per floor. Why can't she ask for a treasure? Something that money can buy that won't die when I give up. For some earth, a bit of earth. She wants a little bit of earth. She'll plant some seeds. The seeds will grow. The flowers bloom. Their beauty, just the thing she needs. She'll grow to love the tender. Lily's fair, the iris home, and then in fall, a bit of earth will freeze and kill them all. A bit of earth. A bit of earth.
Close the shutters and lock the doors.
Brace the windows as in it pours.
Candles only the ones you carry.
Watch now.
Care for the stairs.
Working in pairs.
Fares well the house that's ready.
Come in a tenable store.
To strike again.
Standing, waiting, I think of her. I think of her.
Strange, this marriage. She leaves the room, yet remains. She lingers on. Something stirs me to think of her. I think of her.
From death she casts her spell. All night we hear her sighs. And now a girl has come who has her eyes. She has her eyes. The girl has Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes that saw him happy long ago. Those eyes that gave him life and hope he'd never known. How can he see this girl and miss those hazel?
She has her eyes. The girl has Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes that closed and left me all alone. Those eyes I feel will never ever let me go. How can I see this girl who has her hazel eyes? In Lily's eyes a castle this house seemed to be, and I the bravest knight became. My lady fair was she.
She has her eyes, she has my Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes that loved my brother, never me. Eyes that never saw me, never knew I longed to hold her close, to live at last in Lily's eyes.
Imagine me a lover.
I longed for the day she'd turn and see me standing there. Would God had let her stay.
Someone is crying, just now I heard them. Someone in this house is crying. Why won't they tell me? I know they're lying. Someone here is lost or mad. I must try to find them, beg them stop, so I can sleep.
Someone crying. You ghost?
No, I am not. I am Mary Lennox. Archibald Craven is my uncle.
How do I know you're not a ghost?
I'll pinch you if you'd like. That will show you how real I am. Who are you?
I am Colin. Archibald Craven is my father. I see no one, and no one sees me, including my father. I am going to die.
How do you know?
Because I hear everybody whispering about it. If I live, I may be a hunchback. But I shan't live.
Well, I've seen lots of dead people, and you don't look like any of them.
Dead people? Where did you come from?
From India. My parents died there of the cholera. But I don't know what happened to them after that. Perhaps they burned them.
My mother died when I was born. That's why my father hates me.
He hates the garden, too.
What garden?
Just the garden your mother liked. Have you always been in that bed?
Sometimes I've been taken to places at the seaside. But I won't stay because people stare at me. And one time, Grand Doctor came from London and said to take off this iron thing Dr. Craven made me wear and keep me out in the fresh air. But I hate fresh air and I won't be taken out.
Well, if you don't like people to see you, do you want me to go away?
Yes. But I want you to come back in the morning and tell me all about India. In the books my father sends me, I read that elephants can swim. Have you ever seen them swim? They seem altogether too large to be swimmers. Unless perhaps they use the air.
I can't come and talk to you in the morning. I have to go outside and look for something with Dickon.
Who's Dickon?
He's Martha's brother. He's my friend.
If you go outside with that Dickon, instead of coming here to talk to me, I'll send him away.
You can't send Dickon away.
I can do whatever I want. If I were to live, this entire place would belong to me someday. And they all know that.
You little Roger! If you send Dickon away, I'll never come into this room again.
I'll make you. They'll drag you in here.
I won't even look at you. I'll stare at the floor.
You are a selfish thing.
You're more selfish than I am. You're the most selfish boy I ever saw.
I'm selfish because I'm dying.
You just say that to make people feel sorry for you. If you were a nice boy, it might be true. But you're too nasty to die!
No, don't go. It's just that the storm scares me so. That if I went to sleep, I'm afraid I might not wake up.
Then, close your eyes, and I will do what my Ayah used to do in India. I will pat your hand and stroke it, and sing something quite low.
And I have such terrible dreams.
I have bad dreams too. Last night I dreamed about my father, only he had this lump on his back like your father. And when he turned around, he was your father.
Some night I dream that a round-shouldered man comes in my room on a beam of moonlight. He never says what he wants. He just sits with a book in his hands. And then I dreamed that the round-shouldered man took me off on a ride through the moors by moonlight. He never says where we'll go. We just ride across the hills till dawn. And some night I'm going to ask him, is the night sky black or blue? Good and true.
It's no wonder you have bad dreams. The shadows in this room are so strange.
And once I dreamed that the round-shouldered man took my hand and we walked to a secret garden. I heard my father speak my name as we sat in the crook of a broken tree.
And some night I hear you should ask him how the old moon turns to new.
I knew the answers in his book of all that's good.
Collins.
Yes. Mary Lennox, right. You foolish child.
I was afraid of something like this. He must have his rest. If she'd
but
been
I've
here.
Fight him before.
Right. How can I hope to succeed with him if my orders are not followed?
I told her to stay in her room, Doctor, but she refuses to obey.
What is that infernal wailing?
It's the servants, Rose. The cholera. It's quite bad. I should have sent you away while there was still time.
But what? It's exactly what they deserve, letting us to each from the streets.
How are we going to get around with all the dead and bringing pain?
Oh, but she's not there.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow?
Not too well, she said, see the lilies dead, dig it up, and out you go.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow?
Far too hot, she cried, see my rose has died, dig it up, and out you go.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? Oh, it's dry, she wailed, see the iris fell, dig it up, and out you go.
Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow?
And an early frost now is on, it must dig it up and out you go.
Mary!
It's a big old house with something wrong inside it. Spirit, haunt the halls and make no effort now to hide it. And the master hears the whispers on the stairways dark and still, and the spirits speak of secrets in the house upon the hill.
Archie? Archie, you must tell me what we are to do with Mary. She goes where she wants to go, does what she wants to do. I cannot hope to succeed with Colin's treatment if she continues to sneak into his room and disturb him. We must send her away before she undoes everything we have tried to do.
I can't send her away, Neville. She has no one on the earth but me. Can't you keep her outside? She likes the gardens, I believe.
What are you doing, Archie?
I'm leaving, Neville. You have things well in hand.
Well in hand? Haven't you heard anything I've said?
And last night, I dreamed. I walked through the maze to Lily's garden, and I saw Lily and Mary standing there. Mary standing right there in Lily's garden. I turned away. I couldn't watch. I was afraid.
Why can't he say what he wants? Why must he speak in dreams? Why can't he see what he wants? To disappear, it seems, he should send this haunted girl far away. Leave the house and lands to me.
I watched them walk around the garden. She stood tall, grown strong and bold. Then they turned and asked my pardon. I couldn't speak, my heart grown
cold. Why can't he see what he wants? He wants the past undone. Why can't he know what he wants? His losing battles won. To have never loved her, never known how complete a loss can be. If she could disappear, he'd start again and live like other men. He could be happy then. If she disappear, he could be free, cut off from pain and loss, a bit like me.
Lily, you can't marry this Archibald. He's a gloomy, miserable cripple who hides himself away in that horrible house. Well, you've said it yourself. He can't believe you love him, and neither can I.
No one is asking for your approval, Rose.
Lily, if you don't care about yourself, think about your children. Do you want your children to be crippled as well?
I will marry him.
I can arrange what he wants.
Don't do this.
He's left it all to me.
Don't wed him.
Now he can have what he wants.
Don't wed him.
Unfettered he
don't
will
do
be.
This.